Thank you for joining this video about Emu, a new text-to-image generation model by Meta AI, which was presented in a research paper titled Emu, Enhancing Image Generation Models Using Photogenic Needles in Haystack. Text-to-image models are able to get a prompt as input, such as a cat trying to catch a fish, and yield a high-quality image in response that match the input prompt properly. In this case, we are happy with the result. However, it is not always easy to get high-quality results from these models. In this illustration, for example, we can subjectively say that the second generation is less appealing. So here comes Emu, a text-to-image model which is quality-tuned to yield high-quality results consistently. In this video, we will explain this research paper to understand how Emu was created. Let's first quickly look at several examples of images generated by Emu. In the following figure from the paper, we can see 6 images generated by Emu and their prompts at the bottom. These images exemplify the highly aesthetic generation capability of Emu. Here are a few more selected examples. Again, we can see amazing details here. And finally, a last set of selected examples that includes an Emu that was generated by the Emu model, which we can see on the right. Alright, let's now dive into how Emu was created. Emu was created in 2 stages. The first is called the knowledge learning stage or pre-training stage. In this stage, we take a latent diffusion model and train it on a large meta-internal dataset of 1.1 billion images. By the end of this step, the model is capable of generating images for diverse domains and styles, including highly aesthetic images. However, the generation process is not properly guided to always generate highly aesthetic images, and so it may not be consistent when trying to do so. For this reason, we have the second stage, which is called quality tuning. In this stage, we already have a pre-trained latent diffusion model, and we fine-tune the pre-trained model on another dataset of high-quality images. By the end of this step, the model is now named Emu, and the model is now strong in generating highly aesthetic images consistently, such as the example we just saw, and we'll soon review some of the results published in the paper that show this. What's special here is that this dataset is very small, as it only contains few thousand images. These images are carefully curated to be extremely visually appealing. The curation pipeline starts with a set of billions of images. The first step is automatic filtering, which reduces the set of images to 200k. This step includes various filtering rules, such as removing offensive content, removing images that has a lot of overlaying text, removing images with low clip score, and various others. Clip is a model that connects text and images to the same embedding space, and if we paste an image with its caption via clip, we want the embedding we get for the image and the text to be similar, and if it's not similar, we count the clip score as low. The next step in the pipeline is done by humans, which reduce the set of images to 20k. In this step, they have used generalist annotators, which add a basic task to filter out images of low or medium quality that manage to pass the automatic filtering step. The third and last step is also done by humans, which bring us to the final high-quality images dataset. Here the researchers have used specialist annotators, who have good photography principles understanding, and they have guided them to keep the best images the tensor guidelines about lighting, color, contrast, background, and more. In the following figure from the paper, we can see few examples for images that meet the criteria the researchers were looking for. If we zoom in a bit into the latent diffusion model, then we will notice it is slightly different than usual. Latent diffusion models are known to have a unit that learns to predict the noise in an image that is then removed in each iteration. The unit works in the latent space, and so before passing the input via the unit, it is being encoded by an autoencoder. The commonly used autoencoder has 4 output latent channels, and the researchers have found that increasing the number of channels significantly improves reconstruction quality, and so they use 16 channels. This is of course not a full description of latent diffusion models, which we won't dive into in this video. If you'd like to see a full video about diffusion models, then please let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed this content, then please also subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. Let's now review some of the results presented in the paper. We start with the effectiveness of quality tuning. In the following charts from the paper, we can see comparison between the pre-trained model in red without the quality tuning stage and Emu, which includes the quality tuning stage in green. The comparisons were done using human annotators. On the top left, we see comparison for visual appeal test, where the annotators ranked the output from 2 models only based on its visual appeal, and they did not even see the prompt that was used to generate the images. The quality-tuned model clearly outperformed the pre-trained model here. On the top right, we can see the comparison of text faithfulness. where here the annotators do see the original prompt and are asked to only select the image that best describes the prompt and ignore the visual appeal of the output. Here also the quality-tuned model outperforms the pre-trained model by a smaller margin. The reason the numbers are not summed up to 100 is that in the rest of the cases there was a tie. In the lower two charts we can see similar trend for both metrics when measured over stylized prompts. For example, prompts that ask for a sketch or a cartoon. In the paper, the researchers also show few examples of image generation for the same prompt from the pre-trained and the quality-tuned models, which we can see now, where the pre-trained result is on the left and the quality-tuned is on the right. Next, the researchers also compared the visual appeal of Emu with SDXL, one-party and open user input prompts. And we can see the results in the following table from the paper, which shows that Emu wins SDXL by a significant margin. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you again in the next video.